Something that quite weight on my shoulder, but are very important, very, very important, because for any one of us as a cinematographer, receiving a recognition, an international recognition, particularly from Academy and from the Society of Cinematographers, means that we can prove it that in every country that we belong, and particularly in those kind of places where we should push the, what is the main request, the personally myself, not mainly everybody is doing, to have a worldwide recognition as a co-author of the film. Because till now, the only author being recognized by the law is the director, the writer, and the musician. But cinema is an special image mainly. So it's correct everything, but I think we need to recognize also the images. I am a kind of living proof that a lifetime achievement award is not just a prize for the end of a career. Those represent my 45, 46 lifetime achievement award. That means that make me so proud of the fact that an academy and a society recognize the path, the journey that I'm doing, that can be visible. Like it's visible the language of a writer recognized through his own word, like it's visible the language of the musician through reading, listening to some of his notes, or a painter and recognize some of his style of color. Because I think the language of light is really has the same kind of power of the any other expression, particularly in visual art. Is a chance that I had, thanks to many, many people, that from the first moment that my father pushed me to study photography and cinematography, the great collaborator that I had, the great teacher that I had in school, the great director that I worked with, really made me think that I was able to perform in the way that you saw so many iconic images. Tonight I realize there are many, many images that really become iconic, but like symbolic image. I mean, I was shocked to watch myself over there. That means that I tried very hard to make this journey visible in lighting so many images in different movies with different directors. I tried to, tonight I was even surprised to find some of my book here that I knew that was out of print since almost 15 years. And they still have somebody here that writing with light. And I tried to express myself into this literature, major image of books. I tried to leave an imprint on every seminar, masterclass, lesson that I do in any academy, school, institute of cinematography, and so on. Because I think that anything we do in every profession, particularly if you really believe in what you're doing, particularly if you love what you're doing, practically you try to understand who you are. So you try to understand the meaning of your own life. And that practically the professional dedication helped me to understand who I am and the meaning of my own life. And I realized that even if it is something very, very, very personal journey, any work that we do, but because we belong as a cinematographer into an art form that is not made by a single person, but is a multiple performance, we are like an orchestra. We have several soloists directed by one director. That's why I don't like to be called a director of photography. I don't want to be in competition with the director. I maybe play the violin or whatever. In other words, without a script, without a story to visualize, and without the director, I do not exist. So only through having the consciousness to having something very creative and very personal in what I try to express, but at the same time I try to express that concept together. The writer, the scenographer, the costume designer, the editor, the musician, and all of us need the final approval and need the direction of the director. I was very lucky in my life. Even if you are lucky according to your, not your destiny, you build your own destiny. Sometimes to say no to some project is much more important than to say yes. Because that means that you are telling everyone that you don't want to go in that direction. But maybe you are, your life going another direction. And you're meeting project, meeting directors, meeting a subject. And one way to know if you have the chance to understand what belongs to you, to your own part. The last example, when Tony was talking about the reason why there was not completely in agreement from the beginning, when Woody Allen called me, apart the fact that I needed to investigate if it was true, that I was not interfering with the relationship with Darius Conji, the same thing I did for Apocalypse Now. I did refuse Apocalypse Now at the beginning, because I don't understand why Gordon Willis, the Big Godfather Part 1 and Part 2, with Coppola, didn't Apocalypse Now. Only when after Francis explained to me, he told me this is not Gordon movie. Not only for political reasons, but all because he loved to be mainly in studio in New York, he don't like to be in the jungle, and also politically he's probably thinking in a different way. And I said, can I speak directly with Gordon before to give an answer? He said, not that, I organized the meeting between you and Gordon. And after I said, but Francis, why me? What do I have to do with a war movie? And Francis said, great director. He directed me right away. He told me, this is not a war movie. This is a story that I want to tell because I want to say the truth. This is something that is a universal concept because read Earth or Darkness from Joseph Conrad, and you understand my idea. I want to say the truth that when culture, one country overpowering another culture, another country, make an act of violence. This is something nobody admits. And I want to say that. And I read the Earth of Darkness and realized that it was a universal concept that belonged to every one of us. How much the Roman, the Egyptian, the Spanish, the Portuguese, the English, the French made through the history something like that. That's the concept of what is now. The respect for other culture, the main things. Only after that, I accepted for the movie because I said, this is really belong to me. The main concept of Apocalypse Now, I'm just talking about this movie, that I found the idea to how visualize those kind of theoretical concept. Using the concept of the visual energy, putting the artificial energy on top to natural energy and creating this visual concept. Artificial color on top to natural color. That was a very simple concept, but was a universal concept. And when Woody Allen called me and I said to the agent, apart the speak with the director, let me read the script in order to know which kind of movie Woody want to do. And he said to me, Vittorio, but when Woody Allen called you, you don't ask for the script. I say, no, I do ask for the script. Because first of all, I need to know if the movie that he's doing belongs to my own journey. I cannot do every movie with every director. Not necessarily. Second, I will be able to perform in that story. I will be able to add in the cinematography area something specific like the musician, the writer, and the show are doing So I will be able to write with light the same story in order to really my own profession. And only when Woody sent me the script, I read the script, I loved it, I said yes, not before that. You know, practically you select where you want to go from the beginning. When I was a camera operator, many directors were asking to be a cinematographer. At that time, they were calling director of photography. And I said no, because I was not feeling ready. I was not feeling the kind of movie they want to do, that's something that belonged to me. And probably not even the director, I don't have the kind of magnetic feeling with him, I don't know. I wait him the proper time. One of the things that I tell to many students, don't be in a hurry. Prepare yourself first. And when you really feel that you have enough knowledge, of course you don't have to wait long. You have to be still, be in the first experience. So you have to be also young enough to be provocative at the same time. But be ready, not just be in a hurry. That's a major mistake, major. And that's what I said to Woody, that's what I continue to say to everybody. That's why I was able to meet only some good director from Italy and from all over the world. But mainly I worked with five people. Bernardo Bertolucci, Francis Coppola, Warren Beatty, Carlos Aura, and Woody Allen. Mainly this is my journey. And my guess is that, and my will, is the path that I left behind me, and thank you to the Academy and the Association that recognize those kind of paths. The many young cinematographers that can recognize such path can, with their proper personal creativity, can follow and make even better. I started since 1980, when I received the first Academy Award, to fight in Italy. Today in Italy we have the Italian law recognize us as an author of film photography. But we need to have that recognition worldwide. So if a generation before myself was making such a kind of effort, probably today every cinematographer could have his own author's right. Every time they hear cinematographer discussing the fact that they are not sure, that the editor, the producer, the distributor asking, pushing them to do something or not to do something, I said, because we don't have the other right. That's the main problem. You cannot touch any word on the script unless you have the authorization from the writer. It's so supposed to happen in cinematography. So that's my wish, to reach that kind of recognition worldwide for everybody. In order to do that, we need the young cinematographer continue those kind of journey. Apocalypse Now Redux, I really hope that this print is a print from original Technicolor. I said I hope because I'm not completely sure, in a sense that Francis Coppola decided in 1979 to release the film after 2 years of editing. And he decided at one moment that the only way they can release the movie was to make the storyline very straight, without receiving the a mission. They have those kind of episodes in the jungle when they meet the tiger. The tiger is a symbolic element, like is our unconscious, is our the nightmare that we have into ourselves, the our ancestor. Everything is, let's say, not part of the civil line. Everything from the nature. They decided not to get out of the boat, to continue the journey straight to arrive to Cars. And that's what Francis Coppola decided to do. And the movie was released 2 years later. Step by step, the movie again is on really value. It's been considered by the English Academy the best movie ever done in the last 40 years. In the year 2000, Francis took the decision to go out of the boat. In a sense, they add to the original movie every different segment they cut originally. The French Plantation, the medieval camp, several other episodes, plus some more Marlon Brando scene, because he thought that now everybody digests the major concept that is into Apocalypse Now, and himself, the movie, and the audience can be ready to see Apocalypse Now Redux. When he called me, I went to Los Angeles and I started to reprint all the pieces new edited into the film. The original idea from Francis and Richard Marx, Walter Marx, sorry, the editor, was to keep the original negative in the way it was, print an interpositive, print an interpositive from the new additional negative, do an internegative, and release print from internegative, which is more or less the standard process to release films. But I was facing, and this is something very important for the Filmoteca, with element made in 1979, an element left in whatever room was left 21 years later, when I started to print, and I used the best Kodak film called Premiere, that have much better black because they have much more silver into. And I said, let's use Premiere stock because it's the only way that maybe we can provide the quality of the time that went through these two different negatives. And when I watched it, I see, oh my God, maybe they made a mistake. This is not the film that I asked. This is not because this is it. And practically, what is the time given to us? The color fade. Color fade 1% every year. From the negative, not only the positive. Martin Scorsese made a major drama time ago, but because he was looking at the print. I was watching at the negative. So we have to find some answer about that in any filmotech in the world. And I want to speak with you very privately about this, because we need to preserve our history, our culture, and our film industry in the best way that we can today with the new technology. Anyhow, at that time, I discovered the Technicolor was putting together the original system, Technicolor in the Bishop.